Core functions are operating at full capacity. I trust you're enjoying my company. You and I make quite an effective team. You lead the way, and I'll follow, sir. It's astounding how much we still have to discover out here. Self-diagnostic complete. I'm happy to report I won't be falling apart on you anytime soon. My systems are continuing to function at peak efficiency. It's astounding how much we still have to discover out here.
I'll stop complaining when the there's a story here, we'll... Probably have something you can use.
Thank you.
goes down, crazies come out.
Thank you.
So just looking for a hand. All you gotta do is offer.
I'm really sorry about the smell.
You say the word. Of course.
this article in the newspaper.
Yes.
Blue, something's not right here. This place gives me the willies. Do that. I can barely get mine to save. And inside, there's... You could really win some arguments with what's in here. you ever wonder... Oh, jeez. Sorry. Quiet in here.
sign of them now. Nothing there.
One heck of a getup, Blue.
Thank you. try to be.
Seems like you're doing better than trying. I appreciate it. Too few folks can be bothered. Of course, in my experience, if you want to do real good, playing nice only gets you so far. I mean, look at Diamond City. A place I've been trying to warn of real danger. But every issue I publish, all I hear is, oh, Piper, why don't you ever publish anything happy? Piper, why can't you write something nice for a change? It's enough to make me want to hang.
Sounds like it must be exhausting.
No kidding. You deserve to know the truth. Sure, it can be scary, knowing what's really out there. A night doesn't go by, I'm not afraid some Institute drone will decide. Today's the day to pay old Piper and family a visit. But it's worth it. That's what protects us.
Absolutely. Couldn't agree more. How can you protect you and yours if you don't know what you're facing?
Exactly. Most folks, though, they'd prefer a comforting lie. Not me. I've seen firsthand what the truth can do. My sister and I, we grew up way out in the Commonwealth. Tiny little settlement. Our dad, he was part of the local militia. Keeping the raiders off our backs and the Mirelurks out of our latrines, as he'd describe it. Well, one day, our dad turns up dead. His captain, asshole named Mayburn, claims raiders must have gotten him on watch. Well, I didn't buy it. I start making inquiries. Turns out, captain, he'd sold out. Thought he wasn't getting paid enough to babysit the town. He was gonna leave the gates open one night, let a group of raiders sack the place and take a cut of the profits. My dad found out and was gonna turn Mayburn in, but Mayburn got to him first. And I wasn't about to let that bastard get away with murder. Tried talking to the mayor, but he wouldn't listen. So, I papered the entire town in posters. Wanted for gross dereliction of duty, Captain Mayburn. The mayor sure wanted to talk after that. The town threw Mayburn out on his ass and were dug in when a very surprised group of raiders finally showed.
Piper, you saved those people.
No. Those people saved themselves. Because they knew the truth. But hey, I'm sorry if I've been rambling. I just get fired up sometimes. It's just nice to talk to someone who actually seems to get it, you know? So, should we head out?
Selling papers is busy work, mister.
Soon.
Doc Crocker was.
Hey, you were in the paper, right? Sold well over 1,000 and he did.
He got small on.
Everyone does.
I've got a few minutes to browse.
Don't forget to stock up on ammo.
look like you're about ready to topple over.
Remember, I don't serve scents. Supplies are just for humans.
I'll take a look, sure.
A bit of everything.
Blue, can I get a minute? Something I need to do. Excuse me. Do you feel like
Hey.
Leadership has been responsive to your concerns? Are they really responsive?
I don't want to get into this again, Piper. Can you just bother someone else?
Yeah. Thanks for stopping this time.
Perfection for sale!
Don't touch the paint.
Don't worry, I won't.
Good. The wall keeps out the bad guys, so I appreciate you not messing her up none. Thinking you need a little education. Maybe a bit of community service. What do you say?
Depends on what it is.
You see this paint I'm using? Only one place left in the whole Commonwealth Everybody. You can get it. Hardware Everybody. Town. Ruined store close by to the west. It'll be 100 caps in your pocket.
Only if you throw in some more money.
Fine. Pay you 125 caps.
I think you can do better than that.
A good Samaritan does the work without nitpicking the details. 100 caps, no more.
Paint retrieval. I'm on it.
Much obliged.
And second is our faith and trust in each other. The faith and trust that has given us prosperity, security for every citizen. And while the paper might point their fingers at sins and other ghost stories to drive us apart, we will not betray this sacred trust. Now, I want everyone to hear these next words very carefully. I am not a synth. I am the same flesh and blood boy who grew up on these streets, who was born in a shack just down the waterfront to Martha and Patrick McDonough. And I will not abandon my city due to the heinous allegations of the press. God bless this city! God bless the wall!
Are you here?
Nick? Oh, God. It's really you.
Well, it's hard to mistake this mug for anyone else.
You keep laughing at death. Someday, death's gonna laugh back.
Not as long as I got a few friends to back me up.
You saved Nick, this agency, and my job. Thank you.
Metal detective delivery at your service.
Happy to be in a niche market, that's for sure. Here, every cap we agreed to for finding him. Plus a little something extra. You know, if you're looking for work and don't mind putting on the detective hat, Nick sure could use a new partner.
Whoa. One case at a time, Ellie. Our new friend needs our help first. All right, let's get down to business. Take a seat. Make yourself comfortable. When you're trying to find someone who's gone missing, the devil is in the details. Tell me everything you can, no matter how...
We were in a vault when it happened. Vault 111. It was some kind of cryo facility.
You were on ice, huh? More importantly, you were underground, sealed up. It's a lot of obstacles to get through just to take one person. What else can you tell me?
We're looking for my son, Sean. He's less than a year old. Why would anyone take him?
Good question. Why your family in particular? And why an infant? Someone would be taking on all of his care, and a baby needs a lot of it. Anything else you remember?
There was a man and a woman. They didn't say much. But I remember they called me the backup.
So we're talking a small team. Professionals. Kind that know to keep their lips tight when they're on the job. Not sure what the backup means, though. Well, that confirms it. This isn't a random kidnapping. Whoever took your kid had an agenda. There's a lot of groups in the Commonwealth that take people. Raiders, super mutants, the Gunners. And, of course, there's the Institute.
So you think this Institute is responsible?
Well, they're the boogeymen of the Commonwealth. Something goes wrong, everyone blames them. Easy to see why. Those early model synths of theirs strip whole everything in their way. Then you got the newer models, good as human, that infiltrate cities and pull strings from the shadows. Worst of all, no one knows why they do it, what their plan is, or where they are. Not even me. And I'm a synth myself. Discarded prototype, anyway.
Either way, I need to find Sean.
You're right. The speculation is getting us off track. Let's focus on what you saw. What did these kidnappers look like?
The woman was dressed in, I think it was a kind of hazard suit. The man had some sort of metal brace on his arm.
Maybe some kind of improvised armor? A lot of hired guns do that to look tough. The hazard suit is interesting. Not many mercs can afford something that f***er about them.
One of them came right up to me. Bald head. Scar across his left eye.
Wait. It couldn't be. You didn't hear the name Kellogg.
Oh, yeah. I heard their names, their home addresses, and where their diary keys are hidden.
All right. Calm down. It's way too big of a coincidence. Ellie, what notes do we have about the Kellogg case?
The description matches. Bald head, scar, reputation for dangerous mercenary work, but no one knows who his employer is.
And he bought a house here in town, right? And he had a kid with him, didn't he?
Yeah, that's right. The house in the abandoned West Stands. The boy with him was around 10 years old.
It's Sean. It has to be. Somehow.
Don't jump the gun on me. You said you were looking for an infant, remember? That's over 9 years difference by my count. Look, maybe he has a son of his own. Maybe it's... way they both vanished a while back. Let's you and I take a walk over to Kellogg's last known address. See if we can snoop out where he went.
Security doesn't really go to that part of town, but... you two should still be careful.
I always am.
You've really gone through a lot, haven't you? Hope you and Nick find that monster. The Earl Sterling case. Apparently Earl just up and disappeared one day. No one's seen him since.
I didn't want Ellie to hear, but I think you should know. Everything I dug up about Kellogg before his disappearance.
Oh, wow. You're tall.
He's more than just a mercenary. He's a professional. Quick, clean, thorough. Has no enemies. They're all dead. Except you. 9-1 odds says he's our man. More than just you identifying his distinguishing features. The M.O. was all him as well. Leading a small team to kidnap a baby and leaving one of the parents alive for later? Not many mercs in the Commonwealth can pull that off. Here we are. Keep an eye out, will you? Let's see if I can get this open. That's one heck of a lock. Something to hide, Kellogg? Why don't you give it a try?
Won't be able to pick this. Nick.
No luck? Guess we'll need to find the key. Stubborn lock, ain't it? See that platform in the distance? Near the city entrance? That's the elevator to the mayor's office. Why don't you go ask around there? I'll stay here and see if I can jimmy this lock.
Heard you rescued Valentine. Good work. Old sin scared the hell out of me.
Nicky, he ain't like those instant sinners.
Read that interview you gave. Then you said at the end.
The mayor's receiving visitors as long as they...
Hey, Geneva.
Did you need something else?
I need to talk to someone about Kellogg's old house in the West Stands.
Mr. Kellogg's residence? He left town a while ago. We foreclosed on the property and locked it up. If there was something belonging to the man that you have a claim on, you could ask the mayor to hear you out. No guarantees.
I can feel the gears of bureaucracy grinding me up already.
Like grist in the mill, honey. Good luck.
Ah, yes. I remember you. Our new arrival. I wish I was in your shoes, getting to see our glorious city for the first time. How can I help you?
A man named Kellogg used to live in this city. I need to search his house.
I see. Well, whatever reasons you have, I take my citizens' privacy very seriously. Even after they've left. I can't allow you to invade someone else's home. That's all there is to it.
Please, Mayor McDonough. This man, Kellogg, kidnapped my son. I need to find him.
Oh, of course. I will do everything in my power to help you overcome this horrible personal tragedy. I remember Mr. Kellogg. Didn't like him myself. Paranoid. Never talked to anyone. I doubt you'll find him. But I insist you take the key to his old house. It's been abandoned, though. I'm afraid this whole thing might be fruitless.
Right, let's head in.
Let's take a look around. Kellogg must have left something behind. Place seems small to you. Maybe a guy like Kellogg would think big. Nothing here. Did you check out that desk? Well, that's one way to hide a room.
Gwinnett Stout beer, 44 caliber bullets, and cigars. San Francisco Sunlights.
Interesting brand. Won't lead us anywhere on its own, though. Waiting on you.
What? The great clockwork Dick is stumped?
It's synth detective, jackass. If you're gonna be that way, you might as well get the make and model right. Joking aside, but what about dog meat? Commonwealth mutt like him can track a man scent for miles. Why don't you go fetch him and let him have a whiff? See if he picks up the trail. Before you head out, I know this is personal business. If you have to face Kellogg on your own, just say so. Besides, you already have plenty of company. We can't all go sniffing through the Commonwealth after one man.
I want you with me on this, Nick.
All right, let's get that bastard. This is your show from here on out, okay? You say jump, I'll say how high. Don't let all that horsepower go to your head.
Dog meat. Get the scent, boy. I'm trusting my family's future to a dog. That's it. I'm officially crazy. San Francisco sunlights.
Telling ya.
Kellogg's prefer bread. What do you think, boy? Enough to go on?
Thank you.
bloody bandages. Dog meat can track this.
That nose is second to none.
What do you think, boy? Enough to go on?
Thank you.
always wondered what you'd look like as a robot.
Dog meat. Get the scent, boy. I'm trusting my family's future to a dog. That's it. I'm officially crazy.
Dog must have stopped here. Search around, see if we can pick up.
Thank you.
barely tell us apart.